In this video, we're going to learn the steps of equivalent circuits by doing an example. So here's our complex circuit, and we want to find the Thevenin equivalent circuit for that complex circuit. So we want to find what the value of this voltage source is in the Thevenin equivalent, which is V Thevenin, and what this resistor value is, the R Thevenin. So if you remember from the previous video, the first step when you're determining equivalent circuit is to always remove the load. So here in this diagram, here's our RL right here. I'm going to remove it. Okay, so that's always the first step. And the terminals where the load is connected, those are the loads, those are the terminals of interest. So I'm going to use AB to indicate the terminals of interest. So you see that's where we're getting the equivalent circuit at. Remember, equivalent circuit, this whole theorem is node specific. Okay, so you're getting the equivalent circuit at two nodes. And now we have a choice as far as what our next step is. And what I'm going to do here is I'm first going to determine the voltage across this open. See, once you remove the load, the voltage across that open, that's V open circuit. Okay, and that's the voltage that by definition is equal to this Thevenin voltage of the voltage source in the equivalent circuit. So now the way you find this voltage across the open is by using any of the methods that we've discussed. You know, you could use a superposition method. You know, we've got the two sources here, so you could find the voltage across the open due to the 10-volt source, then find the voltage across the open due to the 20-volt source, and then algebraically sum those voltages to get the open circuit. You could do mesh current. You only have one mesh here. Since there's an open, this isn't a complete loop, so it's not a mesh. So you could do a KVL here. Then once you have the current, find the voltages across the elements, then find the voltage across these nodes here to end up with the open circuit. And you can use a node voltage method. And that's the method I decided to use. Here's our ground node, which is node B. This node here is known. There's 20 volts at this node. And then this voltage at this node is known. Now it's minus 10. Okay, notice that the plus, the higher voltage end of the 10 volt source is grounded, so we would have minus 10 volts here. And then we have a node here that's unknown. And we also have a node here, node A. Now, real key to this problem is noticing that there's no current through this 3 ohm resistor. Right? No current because it's not part of a complete path because of this open. So remember, we've seen this before. It was a while ago, but we have seen it before that when you have zero current through a resistor, that means there's 0 volts across it, right? That comes right from Ohm's law, right? V equals R times I. So no current through a resistor, 0 volts across. And then also remember that 0 volts across something, like a resistor with no current or a short, means that the voltage is the same on both ends. So whatever this voltage at this node is, and I'm just going to label it N. Okay, that's node N. Well, whatever this voltage at this node is with respect to ground, that's going to be the same voltage on the other side of that 3 ohms since it doesn't drop any voltage, and that is our answer. Okay, that will be the voltage we're after, and that's what this source value in our Thevenin equivalent circuit will equal. So we just have to set up a node voltage expression at this node here. So I'm going to say there's a current like this that I'll label I1, and I'll say there's a current going down like this that I'll call I2. Squeeze it in there. Okay, so I'm just going to have at node N, right, my KCL at N. Okay, that's supposed to be an at symbol. But we'll just write it out. At node N will be I1 flowing in equal to I2 flowing out. because no current here, like we said before, through the 3-ohm. So now I'll write those currents in terms of voltage using Ohm's law. So I1 is going to be 20 minus Vn. And then I2, now I2 is going to be Vn minus a minus 10, right? Because like we said, there's minus 10 at this node here. Okay, divided by 6. All right, and if you go ahead and you solve for Vn, you'll see that Vn comes out to 10 volts. Okay, so Vn is the voltage at this node with respect to ground, and like we said previously, since there's 0 volts across the 3-ohm resistor, this is also the open circuit. Okay, which by definition, you know, 3 dashes meaning by definition is VThevenin. Okay, so you see this voltage source right here is 10 volts. We found one part of our Thevenin equivalent. Okay, now we need to find RThevenin. And as I mentioned in the previous video, one way to get RThevenin, and that's the way we'll do it here, and then I'll show you the alternative way in a future video, but one way to get VThevenin that always works is that you take, VThevenin and divide it by I short circuit. Okay. Again, remember VThevenin is the same as V open circuit, and I short circuit is the same as I Norton. So usually you'll see this VThevenin over I Norton or V open circuit over I short circuit. I kind of switched them here, but it's still all the same. All right. To do that, we're going to solve for I short circuit because we have VThevenin, right? We just got that. That's 10 volts. So we need to get I short circuit. So as you notice, I have the same circuit here, the same original circuit drawn. And now to get I short circuit, well, you always do the first step, remove the load. Okay, so we get rid of RL. Okay, but now to get I short circuit, we're not going to leave an open between AB. Okay, this is still node A. This is still node B. Okay, to get I short circuit, you have to put a short between nodes AB. And then you see it's the current that flows in that short between AB. That's your I short circuit. So you see, when you get I short circuit, you're replacing the load with a short. When you're getting V open circuit, you're replacing the load with an open. Okay? So now, to find I short circuit, you just use any of the methods we talked about. Superposition, mesh current. Now, if you do mesh current, you'd have two meshes, right? Say you define a mesh current going clockwise called I1, and then a mesh current over here in this mesh going clockwise labeled I2. Do your KVL equation, solve for your mesh currents, and then whatever I2 comes out to, that would be your I short circuit. Well, I'm just going to go ahead and use node voltage method again. So using node voltage method, now my ground node is actually all of this. Okay, see, that's all ground, because once I put a short between AB and where node B is ground, that makes it all the same node, right? That short makes it all the same node. See, when there is an open between AB, there was two separate nodes on each side of the open, right? But a short makes it all the same node. And these are known again, right? This node is known. This node is known. So we only have one unknown node. Okay, this time I'll label it X. I think X is a little easier to draw with this pen than N. Okay, now we do a KCL. Okay, at node X. So I'm still going to have I1 flowing up. Okay, I'm still going to define it the same way I did in the previous problem. I2 going down. And now I've got a current I3, right? See, no current over here because of the open, but now there's a current flowing through this 3 ohm because there's a connection because of that short. So it's part of a complete path. So I'll define I3 going this way. Alright, so my KCL equation, I've got I1 flowing in, and that's going to equal I2 plus I3 flowing out. Okay, writing these currents in terms of voltages and Ohm's law, we'll get 20 minus Vx over 3. I2 is again going to be that node at the top there, Vx that I'm calling it this time, minus a minus 10, so I'll just write that as plus 10 over 6. And now I3 is going to be just Vx minus 0. Alright, because again, see this side is now ground. That short connected it to ground. So I3 will be Vx minus 0 divided by 3. Okay, now if you go ahead and solve, you get that Vx is equal to 6 volts. So one thing to note here is that, you know, these are two separate problems because in one case there's an open between AB and in the other case there's a short. So one thing you don't want to do that sometimes students have a tendency to do is that when they start doing their I short circuit problem, they'll start taking values that they got from their open circuit analysis. Well, these values are totally irrelevant. This is a whole different problem now because of the short, because as we said, in this problem with the open, there's no current through that 3 ohm. This problem with the short between AB, there is current through the 3 ohm. So you see, you got to treat these as two separate problems. All right, well, we still haven't gotten what we're after. We're after I short circuit. Now, we have the voltage at this node with respect to ground. That's Vx. So how does that help us get I short circuit? Well, look, right here where I3 is defined, I3 is the current flowing into the short. See, that short and the 3 ohm, they're in series. So the current through the 3 ohm is the current through the short. So all we have to do to get I short circuit is just solve for I3. Alright, and we just plug in Vx right there, so we're going to get 6 over 3, 6 volts over 3 ohms. Okay, which is 2 amps. So you see that's I short circuit. So now our Thevenin is just going to be 10 volts divided by 2 amps, 5 ohms. Okay, so that's our answer for this resistor value up here. Our Thevenin, 5 ohms. Okay, so you see that's our Thevenin equivalent circuit for this complex circuit. It's a voltage source of 10 volts in series with a resistance of 5 ohms. Now the last thing here before we end this video is the steps for Thevenin equivalent circuit are the same steps for Norton equivalent circuit. So you see we have the Norton equivalent circuit right now. In fact, let's write that over here. Squeeze in the Norton equivalent circuit representation. Okay, remember, a Norton equivalent is a parallel circuit of a current source and a resistor. Okay, well, as what was talked about in the previous video, the Thevenin resistance and the Norton resistance are the same resistor value. So you see, this is going to be 5 ohms, just like it was over here. Okay. The value of the current source in the Norton equivalent is I short circuit. So you see this would have a value of 2 amps in this problem. Okay, so the key point here is that once you have one of these equivalent circuits, you have the other. It's the same steps to achieve either equivalent circuit. It's just that you're showing the results in a different way. Thevenin, you're showing the result as a series circuit of a voltage source and a resistor. Norton, you're showing the results as a parallel circuit with a current source and a resistor. Okay, we'll do more with this problem in the next video.